Namaste, I am Vijay Ganesh.
In the previous video, we have discussed about Ashtanga Yoga. It's having 8 steps. Yama, Niyama, Asana, Pranayama, Pratyahara, Dharana, Dhyana and Samadhi. In this 4 up to number 4, that is external practice. Okay. Next, 5 to 8 is internal practice. This is Bahiranga Yoga. Up to here, and partially Pratyahara also Bahiranga, and we can consider after practice of Pratyahara, when the person reaches Pratyahara, then it is internal. So we can include it in internal practice, Antaranga Yoga. These 4 practices are internal practice, Antaranga Yoga. This is Bahiranga, we can find the person is practicing. The other person can identify this person is practicing this. But this 5 to 8, the person cannot identify what the person is doing. That's why this is called, these 4 items, Pratyahara, Dharana, Dhyana, Samadhi, is considered as Antaranga Yoga. And these 4 things are considered as Bahiranga Yoga. And now we will see in detail what is this each item. Okay. First is Yama. Yama is the universal discipline that each and every person should maintain in their life. This is the Niyama or discipline for whole world. Based on this Yama, all religious practices are maintained. First, there are 5 limbs of Yama. First one is Ahimsa. Today, I will discuss about Ahimsa. In this video, I will discuss about Ahimsa. What is Ahimsa? Ahimsa is the opposite word for Himsa. Himsa means cruelty. Ahimsa means non-cruelty. Non-violence. That and all you can call Ahimsa. How to practice Ahimsa? Manasa, Vacha, Karmana. With these 3 means, we have to practice Ahimsa. See? Manasa, Vacha, and Karmana. These 3 means we have to practice this. Manasa means by mentally. You have to practice Ahimsa. How to practice Ahimsa mentally? We should not hurt anybody. That is the practice of Ahimsa with Manasa. Mentally we should not hurt anybody. That is Ahimsa. Vacha means by speech. By speech, there is a habit of the person to hurt somebody. That is vacha, with speech hurting somebody. See? This is emotionally with speech, and karmana, physically hurting somebody is karmana. These are the 3, with these 3 means, we should practice Ahimsa. See, only practicing Ahimsa for others is not Ahimsa practice. We should adopt ourselves also. We should not feel any hurt. See, that is the practice of Ahimsa.
idea behind the Ahimsa is we should not hurt others as well as ourselves. Okay? And Ahimsa, Lord Buddha become famous by practicing Ahimsa Tattva. Lord Buddha says that Ahimsa Paramo Dharma. That means it is the greatest dharma in this world. Whole humanity is based on this Ahimsa Tattva. Because of Ahimsa Tattva, whole humanity, all religion are based on. See? So, if you practice Ahimsa, what will happen? That kind of aura, the energy sheet developed around our body, Ahimsa, that aura convert other person to not creating problem to others. That Ahimsa aura will develop, the person to person, it will develop by one person to other, other person to 10%, 10% to one village, see? One village to one Rajya, state, from other state to a country, from a country to whole world, it will, this Ahimsa Tattva helps to create the peace, harmony, and it gives wisdom and strength to the humanity. So that's why this is very important aspect of yoga, which is adopted by all religion, all people in this world should practice this. Okay, thank you. Namaskar.